Hi there, this is Nikki Rowland, designing for UK Scrap Addicts, and today I'm making a layout using the free cut file this month that just so happens to have been designed by me. So I've cut the cut file in a grey colour and I'm planning to have a white background. I'm using the Echo Park Summer Dreams collection, and I have lots and lots of little bits and pieces left over, lots of scraps. And I plan to backfill every single gap with a different paper from the collection. It's going to take me quite a while because I'm hand cutting, so I'm doing it with a pencil, drawing round, cutting out, and then sticking in place. And I'm going to do that for every gap, and there's quite a few of them, so just bear with me on this one. I will super duper speed this up. But this month's theme over on UK Scrap Addicts is all about clusters. And this cut file has been designed with clustering in mind. So you can see where the three words are: hey, hello, hiya. They are all in the three different areas on the layout, and they are going to be the basis for my clusters. If you don't have such an obvious sign, then one trick I find that I use quite a lot is just to add three pieces of washi tape to different areas on my layout, and then use those as a base to build up my clusters around. Normally, they are dependent on where the photo is, as to where the clusters would go. But on this occasion, because I have the three words already pre-cut, that's where my clusters will go, and I'll position my photo, with those in mind. Hooray! All parts of my layout are now backfilled. Once I was stuck in place, I've just added some sellotape over the joins to make it a little bit more secure in places. And now I'm going to raise up the whole thing onto my white background with foam pads. So you just saw me add the foam pads, but then I decided that I needed a bit of colour to go behind the cut file on the edges of the layout. So I've just added some yellow ink to a piece of packaging, spritzed some water over it, and now I'm placing that yellow colour on the edges of my white cardstock so that it will show around the edges of my cut file. Okay, so that's just given the background a bit of a yellow glow. Yellow is one of my favourite colours to scrap with. It's so bright and summery and happy, I love yellow in my layouts. So I just wanted a bit of a yellow background there. I could have used yellow cardstock, I suppose, but this was more fun. So I've just popped my cut file, backfilled cut file, onto my layout, and now I'm working out where my photo is going to go. I have just mounted that photograph onto a piece of brighter coloured paper to give it a bit of an outline. And I've got that positioned in the top right. So I'm touching it against the word hey, and that is going to form the basis of my first cluster. I'm fussy cutting some ice creams there because there were some cute ice creams left over in the bits that I had left for the collection, and that goes really well with the photograph on this layout. So I've just fussy cut those. At this stage, I don't know whether I'll put them all there on that cluster or if I'll spread them around a bit. So I actually didn't have any embellishments to go with this collection, as in embellishments made to go with the collection. So I've had to pull out some different items from my stash to see what will go with the papers. At this point, I decided that the words didn't show up well enough cut in the grey colour against all the big patterns in the background. So I'm just outlining them with a black pen to make them stand out a little bit more. Now I'm going to spend a little bit of time arranging my embellishments in my three clustered areas. I would normally start off with something of a reasonable size as the first layer to my clusters. So you can see there that next to Hiya, I've got a large heart, and under the word hello, I've pulled out a large circle, well not large, but you know, a reasonable sized circle, and I've tucked that under there. And then from then on, I start building up with smaller embellishments on top of those larger ones. So clusters, I feel, is all about layers. So that's why I would start with something bigger and then work down to add smaller things. I use a lot of embellishments on my layouts, and that's because one day I just was like, why am I keeping all of these embellishments? I've got millions of them and I just don't use them or use enough of them. So I just changed my style a bit and was just like, I'm just gonna throw it all on and see what it looks like, you know, what's the worst that can happen. And I actually really love it. I love the variety and all the different textures and dimensions that come with using lots and lots of embellishments on a layout. This one is a little bit busy even for me, but I like the overall result. So that's great. That's great for me, and I've used a whole ton of embellishments that perhaps have been sat in my stash for a while. Finally, I'm adding a title using these really gorgeous gold thickers that have the turquoise or mint foam core. They're my new favourite style thickers. I'm having to make a letter because I didn't have enough. But you know, can make all sorts of things with a pair of scissors, right? So I'm just adding on my title. It didn't quite fit in the right place. It covered up the Summer Dreams section in the middle, so I moved it around a few times. But ultimately finished off with the Cool as Ice title. And because obviously there's not enough on this layer already, I decided that it needed some sequins. Obviously a bit of sparkle makes everything even better, doesn't it? So I thought I would add some of those. And I'm just going to glue those in place with glossy accents to make sure they don't all fall off later. I used to use glue dots, but now I stick them all down with glossy accents. Even still, they still ping off sometimes, but hey ho, that's okay, one of life's things. So that is my layout complete. I hope you've enjoyed it, and I hope you feel that you've learned something about clustering. This cut file was pre-made with clusters in mind, but you can always add your own clusters. A little bit of washi tape is just perfect. Thank you so much for watching. That was Nikki Rowland.